Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to episode 5. Today we're joined by a very special guest. His name is James Girthy-Gut-Goddard. He will be training for the next 2 days or so, preparing himself for the ordeals to come. Donald John Trump got to 105 life. 5 out of 5, in terms of life score. Which means that he's going to be the front line. Then we have Binzend with 95 life. Then we have Street Soldier. Actually, no, Streets is above Binzend in terms of HP pool with 101 versus 95. Next we have Rhea the Random with 91 HP. And finally Goddard with 15. Let us begin. Right, so the preliminary testing necessitates that, we need to make sure that Goddard doesn't die to the crazy guy. He only has like 15 HP. He does have the best armor to deal with this guy, but... And he always gets a good result when... instinct is low, but... Let's see if he gets battered. Hopefully not. If he does, we will restart. But the idea for this here game is to train up Goddard in terms of instinct, get him a skull mask, just a regular mask from this guy. And we train Donald John Trump in attachment, and we train Binzend. Actually, no, we'll train the fourth lady on sanity. How much did he get hurt? Got hurt a little, right. So he needs to take a trip back to the base every time that he has communications with this guy. Streets is low on prudence. Therefore, it's prudence 4, so it should get to, Prudence 5 by the end of it if he trains with that. Donald Trump. I want Donald's temperance to be at 5 out of 5 by the end of this. Send Goddard back to the psychopathic murderer to have a little chat. Oh shit. We're gonna have a containment breach. Right. So people are gonna die now. But no one important is gonna die. And y'all get to witness what it looks like to have a breach. Whoa there, Nelly. Turn around. Right. Tactics win you the game. Goddard needs to flee. What is this guy's life? Whoa there, Nelly. Is he taking damage? Okay, good. Right, everyone return to your posts. After he's calmed down, Goddard will be the best to have a chat with him. He won't want to escape, and he'll be in a good mood after having bloodlust satiated the psychopath, that is. Getting a bad result, that's what you get. You have to pay attention to this shit. Now, I almost forgot that we can fast forward, so let's double the speed. Keep in mind that doubling the speed also doubles the risk. Oh, he doesn't like this. We're gonna have another breach. Done goofed, right. Only instinct work on him from now on. Well, shit. Actually, Right. Look at James go. Bloody hell. Right, only instinct work for you from now on. Alright. Got it. Some attachment work on Mr. Streets would be well placed. Don't deal damage to James. Oh no. Dealt half of James' life. Okay. This can be dealt with. Right, he gets catered to from now on. Like, can't be having this many disruptions. Also, we're running currently at triple speed, which means that triple the risk is present. We should send Goddard to go and drink frequently, I think. I'm curious to see what this thing does if it times out. use a load of your... Goddard lost his weapon. Two or three more times, and that ought to do it. After this one, I think we'll end it. We're gonna get the clefotic counter up to the red again and then depart prior to it filling. So these are the final choices to end the level with. That was a close one. We get to end it on a pleasant note of having to beat this guy into oblivion. And now, we fill this up one final time. Guess we'll fill it up again till the very end. That ought to do it. Right. After Goddard is done drinking the final cola, this will be the day. Thank you all very much for tuning in. 9 lob points, not bad. I'm coming to you, you who will be reduced to ash like me. It's a good day, as you still shy today. Everything will be peaceful while you are under the fairy's care. I don't remember any of these. We're gonna go with fairies because that sounds the least threatening. As you are aware, there are numerous employees working for our company. A majority of them would like to know more about you as a person. Some will take the initiative and attempt to approach you first. It's rather funny. Knowing who you are will not do anything to improve their odds. There are no regulations to prevent them from coming all the way to your office to interact with you face to face, unfortunately. Seems the one who set those rules in place did not consider situations like this. And I suppose this may be a good opportunity for you to show them that you are generous and caring enough to have chit-chats with your subordinates. Words tend to travel faster than you think. I will not stop you from meeting someone. If there are employees who wish to visit you. But please keep in mind that you do not have to do everything they ask of you. Simply thank them for their efforts. Tell them you hope that they will keep up the good work. That will benefit both parties, don't you think? Are you still following me? What we need is a gesture of goodwill and nothing more. Do not go overboard and listen to whatever nonsense they have to say. Give them a vending machine, and next they will come knocking, demanding. I expect you to make the right decision. I'm in charge of the information team and its department. I'll give you a proper greeting later. Are you planning to open up the information department before starting the day? Confirm.